गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई दिनेश प्रताप सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ईसी, ओरिएंटल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। आई विल टेक लेक्चर ऑन कॉग्निटिव ट्रांसीवर आर्किटेक्चर। दिस इज कॉग्निटिव ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर दैट इज यूज्ड इन कॉग्निटिव रेडियो नेटवर्क। इन वन सिस्टम देयर इज बोथ ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर। What is cognitive radio? Cognitive radio smartly senses and adapts with the changing environment by altering its transmitting parameters such as modulation, frequency, frame, format, etc. In the early days or in the traditional communication, there were fixed radios in which the transmitter parameters were fixed and set up by their operators. Today's era of communication includes software defined radio, where with the help of a software defined radio is a radio that includes a transmitter in which the operating parameters including the frequency range, frequency spectrum, modulation type or maximum radiation power of transmitting power or conducted output power can be altered by making a change in software without making any hardware changes. SDR used to minimize hardware requirements. It gives user a cheaper and reliable solution, but it will not take into account spectrum available. Cognitive radio is newer version of software defined radio. In which all the transmitter parameters change like SDR, but it will also change the parameters according to the spectrum availability. This is basic building diagram of cognitive transceiver architecture. We consider the basic structure of a cognitive transmitter and receiver. Figure divides the usual transceiver structure into three parts: radio frequency part, analog to digital converter, and baseband signal processing part. Three parts: radio frequency, analog to digital conversion, and baseband signal processing. Depending on the particular type of cognitive radio, one or more of those components is made adaptive. In a spectrum sensing cognitive radio, only the RF front end is different from a conventional receiver. Figure shows a typical RF receiver front end. Part of receiver shown in figure, its components including as receiver, including antennas, low noise amplifier, local oscillator, and automatic gain AGC, all have to be wide band enough so that they can operate at all possible frequencies at which the cognitive radio might want to operate. The front end also must be able to select the channel which the cognitive radio is to use by having an adjustable local oscillator, that is a voltage controlled oscillator. This is the basic structure of cognitive transceiver. In this figure, analog to digital converter and radio frequency range or baseband signal processing, three units are combined together to make cognitive transceiver architecture. Front end are radio frequency channel and ADC, analog to digital converter, and there is baseband processing, that is control reconfiguration with the help of RF. Both transmitting and receiving antenna connected to it, to user end and from user. Since the channel selection occurs only after the down converter or at the decoding or receiver stage, down converter mixer, a major challenge in cognitive radio lies in the possibility of receiver saturation through strong out-of-band signals. RF components like the LNA, can be saturated by a signal that is not in the band that receiver wants to demodulate at a specific time, but is still within the overall receive band of the cognitive radio. One possibility of reducing such a strong interference are tunable RF notch filters to demodulate at a specific time, and to clear interference we use RF notch filters that can be placed before the low noise amplifier. However, the hardware cost of such filters is high and the tunability is rather limited. For a fully cognitive radio, the baseband processing also has to be adaptive. So baseband signal processing that also has to be adaptive. Adaptive means change according to environment. This can be most easily achieved by implementing the baseband processing as software on a DSP. Consequently, fully cognitive radio has also been called software radio by many of its proponents. This is the figure of radio frequency receiver front end. In this figure, automatic gain control, automatic baseband filter and local oscillator is used. This is the block diagram of RF receiver, where input signal is passed to receiver filter and then it goes to low noise amplifier, where signal is down converting or decoding, that is routed with local oscillator, and this pass to baseband filter and then to automatic gain control at receiver analog to digital converter. Thank you so much. This is the end of the topic.